for October the 20th. We're broadcasting live via Microsoft Teams live event, also on BCTV, as well as YouTube and Facebook Live. At this time, I'd like to ask everyone to stand for a moment of silence, followed by a pledge to the flag. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. At this time, I'd like to recognize our director of the Berks County Department of Veterans Affairs, Ken LeBron, for a very special presentation. Ken.
Good morning, Commissioners.
Good morning.
Good morning, Commissioners. Thank you for having us. Today, I'm going to highlight and talk about the Berks County Military Hall of Fame, where we recognize service members who've gone above and beyond the call of duty. We recognize those individuals each year at the Veterans Appreciation Dinner Dance. So because our recognition of those service members is only one part of the Veterans Appreciation Dinner Dance, I'd like to start by introducing to you, for opening remarks, Major General New, who's Senior Army Instructor for Wilson High School U.S. Army JROTC program.
Good morning, everyone. Good morning, County Commissioners. Thank you for the opportunity to speak to you on this about our dinner dance. On behalf of Dr. Chris Trickett, the superintendent, and Dr. Daniel Weber, principal at Wilson High School, we thank you for the opportunity again to address the community about this great event. This is the 20th year of this dinner dance, so it's a good tradition that we have here in Berks County, and it's unique to this area. So it's a good event. Last couple of years, we've had an increase in numbers showing up, which is good. Despite the COVID interruption, we still had a good climb in numbers. So we'd like to continue that movement moving forward. I'm not going to be too long. I'm going to turn it over to cadets because they're the more star of the show, if you will. People hear enough from us, from me anyway. There are tickets still available, though. You can reach us at the Wilson High School Junior ROTC program. Or if you'd like more information, you can use our website, wilsonjrotc.com. And then there's a link off of that to more information about the vet stance. But this time, I'm going to turn it over to Cadet O'Brien for more comments.
Thank you.
Hi, I'm Cadet O'Brien. I'd like to say a few things about the vet stance and how its effects on the veterans, which is one of the biggest things I love about the event. It's the fourth year I've been in the program, and cadets and veterans all around love this event whenever it goes on. Veterans, this is a great way for us as cadets and the community to come together and appreciate veterans for all the hard work that they've done for our country, and to appreciate them as all together, give them food, and appreciate them with awards and such. And it's a way for us to thank our veterans for their hard work as cadets and have their families come along and with them and have a great time. And I'd like to pass it over now to Jane Brayfield.
Thank you.
Hello, I'm Cadet Jaden Brightville. I kind of wanted to talk about how much of an impact not only does it have on the veterans, but also the cadets. Cadets love it doing this event every year. It gives them an opportunity to put their leaderships that they've learned in our class to use, and also just spend time with the veterans, understand their experiences, sometimes even ask them to dance. It's just a good time overall. And a lot of cadets take this to heart. When you ask them what the most important event that we do throughout the year, they will say this event, because it is truly one of the most amazing things that we do. But we would like to show you pictures of this event.
sacrifice of our military veterans and service members. Those days are Armed Forces Day, Memorial Day, and Veterans Day. With the support of Berks County Commissioners, Berks County is active in each of those three national holidays and so much more in between. As veterans, military service has taught us along the way that as a people, we're stronger when we stand together with the same common goals, ideals, virtues, and focus. Thanks to our military service members, millions of people can keep on living freely and in peace. This is a proud day each year when you allow me to come to your meeting to recognize some of our comrades in arms who have risked their lives or achieved so much during their military service. The Berks County Board of Commissioners established the Military Hall of Fame in 2009 to recognize the men and women from Berks County who demonstrated gallantry in combat against an American enemy or achieved significant national or international recognition during his or her military service. There are currently 68 members inducted into the Hall of Fame, including seven who've earned the Medal of Honor, America's highest honor for valor in combat. Today, I nominate for induction into the Military Hall of Fame the following three heroes. If approved, I request that their names be included into the County of Berks official history. They will also be honored for Veterans Day this year at the Berks County Veterans Appreciation Dinner Dance, as you just seen on your screens, at Wilson High School on Saturday, November 5th of this year. Our first nominee is Major General David M. Gregg, U.S. Army, Special Recognition and Achievement, Civil War. On June 4th, 1851, he was admitted as a cadet at West Point. While enrolled there, he earned the reputation of a fine horseman, which contributed to his eventual renown as a cavalry officer. Gregg graduated from West Point on July 1st, 1855. Upon graduating from the academy, Gregg received a promotion to second lieutenant, where the start of his tour of duty consisted of assignments to Missouri, New Mexico, California, and Washington, D.C., all before the Civil War. In Washington, D.C., Gregg campaigned against American Indians until 1861. Soon after the Civil War began, the Army promoted Gregg to the rank of captain with the 6th U.S. Cavalry on May 14, 1861, and ordered to the defenses of D.C., where he was attached to McClellan's Army of the Potomac. Gregg rose to Brigadier General by the end of 1862. He participated in major Virginia campaigns between 1862 and 1864, as well as conflicts at Antietam and Gettysburg. His repulse of Jeb Stuart's cavalry on the last day at Gettysburg kept the Confederates from attacking the rear of the Union line, countering Pickett's charge. On August 1st, 1861, the War Department promoted Gregg to Major General and appointed him to command the Army of Potomac's Cavalry Corps. His men remembered him as an officer who always was to be found at the point of greatest danger, but one who could not only lead them into battle, but also bring them out safely. His service as an Army officer during the Civil War was exemplary, and his actions significantly contributed to the victory of the Union and the preservation of the United States of America. Although Major General Gregg was not a native son of Berks County, his wife was from Reading, and together they settled in Reading following his military service. After his retirement from service, he dedicated his life to service and civic affairs in Pennsylvania. Upon his death, he was buried in Charles Evans Cemetery. At the close of World War I, the American Legion Post 12 in Reading named their Gregg Post in his honor. He was so well respected by the citizens of the city that shortly after his passing on June 17, 1922, they erected the life-size equestrian bronze statue of Major General Gregg in the Triangular Park on North 4th Street and Center Avenue in appreciation of his service to the country. Throughout the Civil War, Major General Gregg skillfully led the men under his command and on numerous occasions displayed great courage in battle. Major General Gregg was one of Pennsylvania's last Civil War leaders. Our second nominee is Corporal Bernard Radomski, United States Marine Corps, Navy Cross, Medal for Heroism, World War II. For extraordinary heroism and devotion to duty while serving with Headquarters and Service Company, 1st Engineer Battalion, 1st Marine Division, in action against enemy Japanese forces on the island of Palau in Palau Group on 15 September 1944. After Japanese troops had infiltrated defense lines and set up two automatic weapons, which were inflicting serious casualties and hampering the advances of U.S. forces, Corporal Radomski left the comparative safety of his position and with another Marine boldly advanced on the hostile strong point in daring defiance of the unceasing barrages of merciless rifle and machine gun fire to charge the Japanese emplacement, annihilating eight of the enemy and capturing two machine guns before he collapsed as a result of his wounds. Subsequently evacuated, Corporal Radomski succumbed to his fatal injuries before medical aid could be administered. An indomitable fighter, Corporal Radomski, by his aggressive initiative, tenacious determination, and great personal valor in the face of fanatic opposition, contributed essentially to the success of our operations against his vital Japanese stronghold. His resolute conduct and unwavering devotion to duty throughout a period of fierce hostilities reflect the highest credit upon himself and upon the United States Naval Service. He gallantly gave his life for his country. Our third nominee is Captain Ward Rodney Price, U.S. Army Air Medal, World War II. During World War II, Price served in combat as a first lieutenant in Europe in General Patton's Third Army. First as forward observer in an airplane called Grasshopper, where he flew 43 missions where only 35 were required. As a forward observer, he was responsible for locating and radioing enemy positions for targeting back to command for being shot down, ultimately on that 43rd mission. The pilot was able to crash land in such a way that upon impact, the plane was split in half, where both the pilot and Ward escaped without serious injury. They worked their way through enemy territory back to Allied lines. Price was then given command of a tank. Over the next 241 days of combat, he participated in conflicts at France, Rhineland, Ardennes, Central Europe, the Battle of the Bulge, and the liberation of a German concentration camp, where he later attained the rank of captain. He was awarded the Air Medal, American Campaign Medal, European, African, Middle Eastern Campaign Medal with four battle stars, the World War II Victory Medal, and the Army of Occupation Medal in Germany. A member of America's Greatest Generation, he was a 75-year member of the American Legion Post 12 in Reading. Commissioners, these are our nominations for induction to the Berks County Military Hall of Fame, Class of 2022. We humbly request your approval of these nominations. With your approval, we will enter office certificates of recognition for the 2022 class of inductees for Board of Commissioner signatures to your administration so that they may be presented on 5th November 2022 at the Veterans Appreciation Dinner Dance. As always, thank you for your time, your consideration, and your support of this honorable endeavor.
Thank you, Director LeBron. I will motion to accept the nominations of General Gregg, Corporal Radomski, and Captain Price into the Berks County Military Hall of Fame.
I will second that motion. The motion has been made and seconded. Is there any discussion? I just will add, we do this every year and the stories are never the same. Obviously, they're different people, but I'm always amazed to hear the stories of people that called Reading and Berks County their home and served so sacrificially for our country. Really appreciate. I know there's a lot of research, actually it requires research to do the application, but once the applications are reviewed, I know that Ken, Steve, and Jason are very involved in confirming the details before ultimately individuals are recommended for the Berks County Military Hall of Fame. So thank you very much.
I too would also like to recognize who actually was the genesis of this was Janice Kinkinger, our former VA director, as well as Larry Cohen, when we were at the facility at the North Campus, and they pulled this together and presented that to the Board of Commissioners, who unanimously accepted it. So it's great that it's been going on since 2009.
It is an amazing event annually, and we appreciate your support each and every year as we recognize these individuals. So thank you again.
The motion has been made and seconded. Is there any other discussion? Hearing none, all those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? The motion is carried. I also want to thank Wilson High School, the JROTC program. This event on November the 5th could not take place without the willingness of the Wilson High School to make the venue available, but nor could it happen without the tremendous effort, not just the day of the event. This is something that's almost started a year in advance as it is planned. For those of you that have not been able to attend this event, there's nothing like it that we know of in the country. A number of years ago, the National Association of Counties did an article on this event in their national publication, and to date, just not aware of anything like it. 700 to as many as 900 people at the Wilson High School gymnasium, and veterans everywhere. And our JROTC folks, they really love spending time with the veterans. I've seen JROTC students dancing with veterans, including several times veterans that are in wheelchairs, taking them out on the floor. And I will tell you, we hear every year from the veterans how much it means to them and to their family. So I'm so proud of Berks County, so proud of Wilson High School and the JROTC program. We do have Muhlenberg is involved. That's an Air Force program. Are any of the other ROTC programs? Not at this point. So, but I know Muhlenberg is like in year four or five of their involvement. We appreciate that as well. So I will be there. I think.
I was just thinking, I don't think I've missed one because it's a can't miss opportunity. It's just a great venue. And it's an honor for us to be there to support the honorees and their family members. It's really a great evening. And let's overfill the place that we have to turn people away. It's just an amazing night of entertainment, food, and recognition of people that richly deserve the honor.
Yeah, I look forward to this year. It'll be the first time since this program has been in place that all three Berks County commissioners will be there. I would have been there last year. My mother died that morning, and I was planned to be there and was not able to make it. But we'll be there, fully supportive of the work that you do and our fantastic people at the, Chief Master Sergeant Richard Etchberger Veterans Affairs Center here in Reading. Thank you.
Thank you.
Are there any additions or corrections with the October 13th Commissioner Meeting Minutes? Hearing none, the minutes will stand approved as presented. We did have three executive sessions, one on October the 17th, dealing with real estate and litigation, October 18th, real estate and litigation, and October 19th, litigation, personnel, and real estate. At this time, I'd like to recognize my executive assistant, Anne-Marie Grill, to read the public comment policy.
Thank you, Commissioner Linebach. Public comment will be accepted in person and through the Q&A function. Please include your first name, last name, and municipality for all comments. Any comments without name and municipality will not be considered. Each citizen can submit one comment. Comment length is dictated by limitations of the platform being used, Teams Q&A, Facebook, and YouTube. In-person comments will be accepted first, followed by comments submitted virtually. The meeting comment period is limited to a total of 30 minutes, including both in-person and virtual comments. This time period may be extended at the discretion of the board. Please be concise. Comments that are germane to county business will be read during the meeting and should not be considered to be interactive dialogue with the commissioners. The county solicitor shall be the final arbiter of whether a comment is germane and should be read. Any commissioner response to public comment will be done at the discretion of the commissioners.
Thank you very much, Anne-Marie. There's no public comment on agenda items in person and none online. So we'll move ahead with the agenda. Item one, authorizing under that budget department. Adopt a resolution authorizing 2022 budget transfers in the amount of $387,536 and 2022 appropriations in the amount of $16,215 per listing dated October the 14th. There are several items listed under Human Resources. Item one, authorize the appointment of Caitlin Drobeck to Human Resource Assistant, Human Resources. Item two, authorize the appointment of Angela Bingaman to Office Manager, Recorder of Deeds. Actually, I need to make a note there. We're withdrawing this particular item to get some additional information. Mary Kozak is a Recorder of Deeds. I did speak to her this morning. So this item will come up at some later agenda. Apologize for that. Item three, authorize the promotion of Emily Washburn from certified legal intern to assistant public defender one in the public defender's office. Item four, authorize the promotion of John Grenier from certified legal intern to assistant public defender one in the public defender's office. There's one item listed under Commissioner Rivera. Adopt a resolution authorizing the reappointment. What did I miss?
Authorize the utilization of temporary agency, sir.
Oh, I did. Good catch. That's why we have another commissioner. You never know when the one in charge is going to screw up. Item five, Sergeant at Arms, you can do that. Item five, authorize the utilization of a temp agency for implementation specialist position information systems. Thank you. Commissioner Rivera, one item, adopt a resolution authorizing the reappointment of Dr. Johanna Kelly, MD, Y Missing PA, to the Berks County MHDD Advisory Board for a three-year term expiring on December 31st of 2025. There are several items listed under the commissioners. Item A, adopt a resolution authorizing the appointment of Ryan A. Breisch, Director of the Literacy Council of Reading Berks, to the Berks County Workforce Development Board for a replacement term beginning November 1st of 2022 to June 30th of 2025. Item B, adopt a resolution authorizing the appointment of the individuals listed below to the Berks County Local Emergency Planning Committee effective October 20th of 2022. Andrew Harkle of Reading, Pennsylvania, Candace Mills, Croydon, Pennsylvania, Corey Williamson, Ole, Pennsylvania, John Phillips of Reading, Pennsylvania. Item C, adopt a resolution authorizing the chair to execute the Pennsylvania Commission on Crime and Delinquency Award Notification for a subgrant awarding funds for the Forensic Science Combating Opioids Project with the District Attorney's Office. This resolution amends a prior resolution to reflect the correct amount of the grant totaling $89,426. Item D, adopt a resolution authorizing a letter of support for the Schuylkill River Greenway to secure funding for the repair and improvement of the Thurman Madera Switchback Trail at the Kernsville Dam Recreation Area in Tilden Township. Item E, adopt a resolution authorizing the sending of a letter to the Reading Regional Airport Authority, reaffirming the intent of the Berks County Board of Commissioners to form a Reading Regional Airport Advisory Committee composed of a single representative of each airport tenant that shall meet with the airport authority and airport management on a monthly basis. Item two, a motion to authorize execution of contract agreements and amendments as set forth on the attached listing dated October 17th of 2022. There are a total of 12 contracts, one with the Area Agency on Aging, one with CareerLink, four with Children and Youth Services, one with Children and Youth Services and Juvenile Probation, one with the MDJ's office, one with our Department of Elections, one with the Law Library, and two with Parks and Recreation. Item three, a motion to authorize execution of the payments and electronic transfers as set forth on the Controller's Office voucher listing dated October the 20th of 2022. Item 4, a motion to authorize execution of employee payroll disbursements dated October 25th of 2022. Item 5, a motion to authorize execution of the third quarter of 2022 local earned income tax payment dated October the 20th of 2022. And item 6, a motion to authorize execution of the third quarter of 2022 local services tax payment dated October 20th of 2022.
Motion to approve the agenda as presented.
I will second that motion. The motion has been made and seconded. Is there any discussion? Hearing none, all those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye. Aye.
Opposed? The motion is carried. We'll move now to our treasurer's report. Sitting in for Dennis Adams is the deputy treasurer, Linda Weaver. Linda.
Good morning.
Good morning.
We have an opening balance of $227,580,462.26. We have a balance to clear of $7,479,947.46, leaving us with a balance of $220,100,514.80.
Thank you very much, Linda. And we'll move now to our county controller, Sandy Graffius, with the controller's report.
Okie dokes. Total cash disbursement, $6,577,169.09. We have some payroll costs to pay out this week. EIT, $375,840.86. Local state local tax, $12,223.60, for a grand total of $6,965,233.55.
Thank you very much, Sandy. And now to our Chief Operations Officer, Ronald Seaman.
Thank you, Commissioner. There's nothing to report at this time.
Okay, thank you. And we'll move now to Commissioner Kevin Barnhart.
Thank you, Commissioner Linebach. So it's less than 3 weeks away. Tuesday, November 8th is General Election Day. This coming Monday, the 24th, is the deadline to register to vote. November 1st is the last day you can apply for a mail-in or absentee ballot. And again, we are in preparation, full bore, with making this happen for November 8th. So please, if you've received or have requested a mail-in and absentee ballot and sitting on your countertop or your kitchen table, fill it out and get it in the mail as soon as possible. Don't take any chances, as well as everything else that's taking place. We want to make sure we have a smooth process going forward here. At 11 a.m. this morning here in person and on Microsoft Teams is our election board meeting. A couple of items on the agenda: discuss and approve undated and misdated absentee mail-in ballot process, discuss the risk limiting audit and the 2% audit for the November general election, review and adjudicate absentee mail-in ballots received with taped outer envelopes, and an update regarding the LNA testing on the electronic poll books. So it's a robust agenda, and I look forward to the discussion at 11 a.m. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Commissioner Barnhart. I have nothing to add at this time, so we'll turn to our row officers. Any comments from our row officers? Very good. I have no public comment in person, and I have no public comment online.
Motion to adjourn.
The meeting stands adjourned. Thank you.